Allah brings it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the religion of Allah and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him and his family and his companions and whoever will follow his footsteps until the day of judgment. Brothers and sisters, again, we are a few days away from finishing Ramadan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our fasting, our Quran, our good deeds, inshallah. And my advice for you and myself, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to advise our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from before, to continue our ibadah as we started Ramadan. If you don't do it, we still have the chance. The ending is better than the beginning, important than the beginning. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves somebody, He will guide him to do something at the end of the day for his umr, his life, to do good things, good deeds. And then He will take his soul in this deed. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we think to do good deeds inshallah in the coming 3 days of Ramadan. The best thing you can take with you in Ramadan is your belief, your iman, your faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second thing is your relationship with the Quran. I know Ramadan is the month of the Quran. The Quran revealed to our Prophet Muhammad in Laylat al-Qadr in Ramadan. But remember, we still have another 3 nights. Maybe one of those nights will be Laylat al-Qadr, which is better than 1,000 months. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Laylat al-Qadr khayrun min alf shahr. The Prophet ﷺ used to see in the hadith, رَغِمَ أَنْفِ رَجُمْ أَدْرَكَ رَمَضَانْ وَلَمْ يُغْفَرْ لَهُ. The Prophet ﷺ used to make dua against somebody. He attended Ramadan, but he didn't get the chance to get forgiven, or free, get free from the hellfire. That's why the Prophet ﷺ telling us it's very easy for you to get the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is easy for you to get freed from the hellfire. Just you need to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You need to do your best to do whatever you can to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So did you get the chance? My question is, did you get the chance to understand the Quran? Did you get the chance to think about the Quran, to apply the Quran in your life? I hope if you didn't, please try to do so as soon as you can. We still have time, we still have 3 nights, and we have to remember that our Prophet Muhammad said, مَنْ قَامَ لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ وَمَا تَأْخَرَ. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم, whoever well do qiyam and salat and Quran in the sake of Allah, in Laylat al-Qadr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him the reward for forgiveness, inshallah. Man qama Ramadan. And in the other hadith, as you know, Man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufra lahu ma taqaddama min dhanb. Man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufra lahu ma taqaddama min dhanb. Why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us, you know, different hadith, repeating over and over again? Because it's easy for you. No shayateen in Ramadan. You always, you know, see people coming to the prayer. You know, you discover yourself in Ramadan. You can stand for 1 or 2 hours, standing behind the imam, praying qiyam, and then coming in tahajjud, and still for another 1 hour, reading the Quran, listening to the Quran. Alhamdulillah, you have the will, you have the power to do it. So you discover yourself, alhamdulillah. But the only thing is, you have to continue after Ramadan. Because one of the signs that Allah will accept your siyam and your good deeds to continue after Ramadan. You know, some people plan ahead to do bad stuff after Ramadan. Ramadan finished, we'll get back to work as usual before Ramadan. Would like to be not like that. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma biqawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bi'anfusihim. Did you feel the iman in Ramadan? I am sure that everybody here, you felt your iman is increasing in Ramadan and better in Ramadan. Your moral things is better. Your character is much better. So please continue. You taste it. you taste the closest, you know, you taste the power of Quran, you taste the power of dua, you taste the power to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So please, please don't lose it. Continue with it. Because one of the signs that Allah will accept you and your deeds to continue after Ramadan. Fast in Shawwal. Fast during, you know, Monday and Thursday, as the Prophet ﷺ used to do. Try to finish the Quran every month during the regular days of after Ramadan, inshallah. Try, don't forget the sadaqah, to make sadaqah every week when you come to the masjid. Just to keep, you know, yourself connected with the deeds in Ramadan. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you and will give you more hasanat and more reward, and He will make your life very easy, inshallah. So brothers and sisters, again, Yawm al-Eid is coming. Yawm al-Eid is Tuesday. The celebration in the masjid will be Saturday, inshallah, June 8th. You know, make your family happy. Get with them. Make a good time with the family, inshallah, with your brother. Try to call your relatives, your parents, make dua. And also, don't forget to put a plan for yourself after Ramadan. To be in the same bath of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, in Surah Hud, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and us, at the end of the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him about the stories of other, you know, prophets before our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وإلى عاد أخاهم هودا وإلى ثمود أخاهم صالحا ولقد أرسلنا نوحا إلى قومه إبراهيم لوط موسى all prophets, and at the end of the ayat telling our prophets صلى الله عليه وسلم and us is very big advice. As Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, يا أيها الناس قد جاء وعظة من ربكم وشفاء لما في الصدور. This is the Quran. This is the advice of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. What is the advice for our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, فاستقم كما أمرت ومن تاب معك ولا تطغوا إنه بما تعملون بصير. Allah is telling us and our Prophet, استقم, stay fast. Continue whatever you are doing in the seat of Allah. Continue in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yourself and whoever repent or give back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَطْغَوْا إِنَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ عَلِيمٌ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَا تَرْكَنُوا إِلَى الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا فَتَمَسَّكُمُ النَّارُ. Don't be close, don't be a friend, don't be a supporter to whoever doing a bad deeds, you know, injustice, oppressors, don't be even close to them. Because if you get close to that, those people, Allah will punish you. فَتَمَسَّكُمُ النَّارُ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling the third advice to us and our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَأَقِمَ الصَّلَاةَ طَرَفَيِ النَّهَارِ وَذُلَفًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ ذَلِكَ الذِّكْرَى لِلذَّاكِرِينَ. You know, establish your prayer regularly on time, every day. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, asked by the companion, أَيُّ الْأَعْمَالِ أَفْضَلُ. What is the best deed I can do? The Prophet ﷺ replied, As-salatu ala waqtiha. Pray on time. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, Wa aqim as-salata tarafay an-nahar, fajr time, at the end of the day, wa zulafan min al-layl, salatu al-isha, inna al-hasanat yudhibna as-sayyi'at. Because if you do that, Allah will forgive, will wipe out your deeds, your bad deeds. As the Prophet ﷺ, remember in the other hadith, the Prophet said, Ramadan ila Ramadan, wal-jum'atu ila al-jum'ah, wal-salawatu al-khams mukaffiratu lima baynahunna idha jtunibat al-kabair. The Prophet ﷺ said, from Ramadan to Ramadan, from Friday to another Friday, in between your five prayers every day, Allah will forgive your sins between those times. If you get away from Al-Kabair, awkama qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So brothers and sisters, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our fasting, accept our prayer, to give us the chance and the will to continue inshallah, to make, you know, good khitam, good end of our Ramadan inshallah, and continue after Ramadan bi-iznillah. Remember to take with you a dua first, to stay fast in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember always to say, رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا وَهَبْ لَنَا مِن لَّدُنكَ رَحْمَةً إِنَّكَ أَنتَ الْوَهَّابُ. Remember, not only you, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Khalilullah, friend of Allah, used to say to Allah, رَبِّي وَجْرُبْنِي وَبَنِيَّ أَنَّعْبُدُ الْأَصْنَامَ رَبَّنَا وَاجْعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكَ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِنَا أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً لَكَ وَأَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. To think only about dua, it's ibadah. If you think about just to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a very high level of ibadah. And you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if He guides you to make dua, surely you will accept, inshallah, will answer your prayer. Second, to make infaq fi sabilillah. Don't forget to donate in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every week. Every time you have money, give something to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا جَعَلَكُمْ مُسْتَخْلَفِينَ فِيهِ. As I said in the beginning of the khutbah, and you know, try to attend the salah in the masjid as much as you can. Also, don't forget your family, your spouses, your children, and your friends, inshallah, your dua. نَسْأَلْ اللَّهُ عَمْرُ الْعَصْرِ عَلِمَ اللَّهُ صُبْحَانَهُ مِنْ أَمْحَمْرِ هَذَا إِلَى الْلَبِّ الْمَغْفُورِ وَسَعِي الْمَشْكُورِ وَعَمَلَ مُتَقَبَّلِ الْمَغْرُورِ. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا عصيرا إلا يسرته. اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا وصلاتنا وقيامنا وركوعنا. تقبل منا ختم القرآن. اللهم تقبل منا قراءة القرآن وصلاة القيام والتهجد برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم لا تتوفنا إلا وأنت راضٍ عنا. اللهم لا تتوفنا إلا وأنت راضٍ عنا. اللهم لا تتوفنا إلا وأنت راضٍ عنا. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. Brothers and sisters, also remember Salatul Fitr. It's very important. You have to do it. Do it as soon as you can before Eid, inshallah.